In last video, we have seen how we can install the Django Python, Django along with the Python pip and virtual environment. And after that, we have created our Django project called blog. So in this video, we will go some more detail about that blog. We will create a post and we will see how we can configure the admin, how we can configure the URL part in this video. So let's get started with this thing. So in this video I will cover this Django topics: Django admin, Django settings, Django model, Django admin, Django form, Django view, and Django templates. So for that I'm going to open my window terminal and my editor VS Code, Visual Studio Code. So
Django start project and project name. So project name, I'm going to give part 2. So part 2 will be our project name. So it will create a folder called project name,
and inside that folder it will create a application called part 2.
So
if I hit enter, it will create project.
So as you can see, it has created. Now in our editor, you can see there is a folder called project part 2, and inside that folder we have part 2 application, and that have a configuration file
or setting file. That is a setting.py. Along with that, it also have a url.py and whi5. We will see this these two file later, and this management.py file that will use to our run of project level commands. So if we see this, see our Django configuration file here, we have couple of settings which we can change according to our needs. Like we have a debug true. On production server, we can set this to false. Allowed host, if we have multiple domain, we can put all domain in comma separated. And if we have only one domain, then we can put that domain name here. For development server, we will leave them as a blank. But if you change this debug true setting, that it will not work. So for that, it should be like just like this star. Otherwise, you can put the your domain name. So for example, if we are going to host this application on example.com, then here should be here example.com should entry should be there.
So apart from this allowed host, we have installed app.
So in our application, we will create multiple app. For example, in this project, we will create a app called blog. So blog entry should be here. Similarly, we can add some more applications. So all those app entry should be here, and this is middleware. So we can if we create a new middleware, so middleware related entry should be here. For template relating settings will be in the template part, and the most important part is the database. So for this project, we will use only our SQL database, but on production or any other environment, we can use our MySQL database, PostgreSQL database. So according to our needs, we can change the configuration here. This is for the password related settings. So on the registration page or on our user creation page, we can configure our password rule. Like password should be numeric, should be comma password should not be there, minimum length, so all validation we can put here. And this is for the language or time zone related settings, and this is for the static file related setting. We will see all this configuration in detail later. So for now, if we run this project,
So for that,
that
I
have
already
opened
a new
terminal.
So
let me
browse
that
port
location. Let me
activate
our flow environment. If you are using virtual environment, then you should activate this. Otherwise, you don't need to activate this environment.
So for now,
to run application,
we can run
our management command,
run server.
So run server.
If we can also put here a binding IP
address
like
this.
But by default, it will start our development server on localhost. So let me
run
this command and I
will
show how
it will appear in our
browser.
In our
last video,
we
have
completed
all
these
steps
till
now.
You can see that the video on our channel.
So here you can
see
it has started our
development
server. And
you
can
find
that there is a
port
on the
client
migration.
I will
detail
about this
later.
And
here
you can
see one
more
file
is created like db.sqlite. So this is
a database
related file. Currently we are using SQLite database, so it have created here.
Otherwise
if you use MySQL, it is not created here.
So
if open my browser and
browse
to this location.
So
as you can
see,
default
page
is open because we are using debug crew. If we debug
calls,
then this page will
not
appear here.
So
now next thing is
here we
have
put in
an applied migration.
Migration
is just like
database
related changes which are still in our project
and
not applied to our database. Means we have
created
a file to create
a table,
but that table is not created on our database. So
for
that
we
need
to
run
a command
so that
this
database related
changes
we can apply
to
our
database.
So
for
that
I
will
run a command
here.
So I
will need
to go
to the inside
of
project.
Now
we
can
run
a command
python
manage.py
migrate
is
a
command
we can use to migrate our database related changes to the database.
So we
have
a
Django
come up
with
the
default
module
called
admin
auth content type
and
session.
So
all these four
modules
have
some
database related changes.
Now
we
are
applied those changes to our database. So
database
is our SQLite database. So it will create a table inside the database our database.
Now
it's
all
has
applied.
So if we refresh our
page,
nothing will
happen
because
it's
not
related
to
our
view
part. Now
we have
created
our
admin
panel.
If we
open
our
project
and
var.py,
you
can
find
here
a var
called
admin.admin.
In
URL,
we simply
put
a
different
URL
to open
our view.
So like default
we have
a admin.
So
if
I
browse
to this location,
it will
open
an admin
panel.
Because
Django
default
come up with
the contributor
module
called
admin.
So
now
you
can see
there
is a login
form
where we
need
to provide the username and
password,
but
we
don't
have
any username and
password.
So
for
that
we
can
create
a
username
password
from
here.
So
if
I run
here
command
help,
it
will
show
a
command
to create
a
username and
password.
So we
can
see here
a create
super user
command.
So
if
I type
here
python
manage.py
super
user,
it will
ask
a
username.
So I'm
going
to put
the
username
as admin.
A email address is admin@example.com. You can use your email address. It will use when you want to reset your password.
Now I need to write the password.
So I'm going to use the password.
Now we have created a username and password. So if I use that username and password here,
So now you can see we have two links here, group and user, and a couple of links at the right corner. Admin can change their password by clicking on this change password link. So from here we can change the admin password, and by clicking on this username we can see all the user related information. So currently we have only one user, if we want to create a new user. We can add more button by clicking on this group. Group is basically just a kind of role where we can create multiple roles, like we can create an editor, we can create a manager. We can create a report manager, so different kind of role we can create by using this add group button, and that role we can apply to this particular user. So to apply the role to a particular user, we need to go to this user profile, and from there we can change our group. So we can apply some more group to this particular user, or we can add a particular role, a particular permission to this particular user.
So now we have a default functionality. Our aim is to add a new mod application app to this project, name will be a blog, and we can create a post, and that post will be visible to a normal end user. So let me create a new app called blog. So for that I need to run command python manage.py.
Start app, you can find this command by using help. So as you can see here, start app. So if I type start app and app name, app name will be the blog. Blogs.
Now if I see here, you can see that we have a new folder called blog.
Inside the blog, we have the same structure, admin app model test 5 view.
Now next thing is that we have created our blog, but we don't have an entry here. So every new app entry should be here. So one setting will be changed.
So now we have given an entry to this project.
Blog, and so till now we have added a new application to this particular project.
Now if I refresh here, nothing will be changed because we don't have any table or any configuration in our blog.
Now our aim is to create a table called post.
So every blog should have a post, and where we can create our new blog.
So for that, we need to create a table.
So to create a table, every database related things will be in model.py. So here we can create a model.
So I am using the Django plugin for Visual Post, so it will give us a default template of that particular class.
So I am not going to use this.
So a table should have two columns, one is the title and another is the body or content. So to create a that is
will be
char char
fill.
Title
length
should
should
be
be
100.
You can put your own length.
I don't want to
be
title
to
be
blank
blank or
or
null.
Null.
So
I
I'm
will
going to remove
this.
And
right
here,
we
need
need
to
to
create
create
one
one
more
more column.
That should be a body. A
body
should
should
be.
So we
will
not
use
use
this
this
char
field.
Now,
now
till
till
now
now
we
we
have
have
created
created
two
two
column
in
in
our
our
database,
title
title
and
and
body.
Body.
There is
given
one more
more
information
information
like
like
meta
meta classes,
classes,
so it will use
sorry, so
we
we
need
to
provide a
table
table
name,
name.
So
so
we
we
can
can use
put
put their
their
table
table
name
name
here.
Here.
So
post.
By
By
default,
default
it
it
will
will
appear
appear
as
as
a
a post.
post. If
That
there
is
is a use any
ruler,
ruler, so
so that
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 time
time
it
it
will
will
be
be
used as a
post.
post.
Now,
by
by default,
default,
if
if we
we
print
print
over
over
this
this
object,
object, that
that
object
object
should
should
be
be
visible
visible
as
as
a
a
title.
title.
So,
Because default,
for
for
now
now
let
let
me
me
remove
remove this.
this.
Now
Now
we
we
have
have
created
created
a
a post.
post.
Table,
Table, but
so
so
now
now
we
we
have
have
created
created
a
a
table.
table.
Now
Now
we
we
need
need
to
to
run
run
a
a
command
command
to
to
specify
specify
our
our
project
project
that
that
we
we
have
have
created
created
a
a
table.
table.
So
So
for
for
that,
that
we
we
need
need
to
to
run
run
a
a
command
command
called
called
make
make
migration.
migration.
So
So
it
it
will
will
create
create
it
it
will
will
collect
collect
all
all
database
database
related
related
changes
changes
into
into
a
a
single
single
couple
couple
of
of
files.
files.
So
So
for
for
that,
that,
make
make
migration
migration
command
command
we
we
need
need
to
to
run.
run.
Migration.
Migration.
So
So
it
it
will
will
create
create
a
a
file.
file
in.
in.
So
So
we
we
have
have
a
a
in
some
some
error.
error.
So
So
I'm
I'm going
going
to
to
remove
remove
this
this
underscore.
underscore.
It, this
This
will
will
be
be
used
used for
for our
our
translation
translation
purpose.
purpose.
So
So
we
we
are
are
not
not
using
using
that.
that.
So
So
that's
that's
why
why
I'm
I'm
going
going
to
to
remove
remove
this.
this.
So
Now
now if
if
we
we
run
run
our
our
make
make
migration,
migration,
it
it
should
should
work.
work.
And
And
now,
now
as
as
you
you
can
can
see,
see,
we
we
have
have
created
created
a
a
file
file
in
in
our
our
migration
migration
folder,
folder,
create
create
model
model
post.
post.
So
So
if
if
you
you
open
open
this
this
folder,
folder,
migration,
migration,
here
here
we
we
can
can
see
see
that
that
we
we
have
have
a
a
migration
migration
related
related
changes.
changes.
Now
Now
we
we
have
have
a,
created
created a
a
database
database
related
related
changes.
changes.
Next
Next
thing
thing
is
is
to
to
migrate
migrate
these
these
changes
changes
to
to
our
our
data,
data,
migrate,
migrate,
migrate these
these
changes
changes
to
to
our
our
database.
database.
So
Migrate.
Migrate.
We
We
run
run
our
our
command
command
migrate,
migrate,
so
so
it
it
will
will
create
create
a
a
table
table
in
in
our
our
database.
database.
So
So
we
we
have
have
created
created
a
a
table
table
in
in
our
our
database.
database.
Now
Now
we
we
need
need
to
to
create
create
an
an
interface
interface
through
through
which
which
we
we
can
can
add
add
our
our
blog.
blog.
So
So
for
for
that,
that
our
our purpose
purpose
is
is
just
just
like
like
our
our
this
this
username
username
group.
group.
I'm
I'm
going
going
to
to
create
create
a
a
new
new
entry
entry
here.
here.
Name
Name
will
will
be
be
a
a
blog,
blog,
and
and
by
by
clicking
clicking
on
on
the
the
blog,
blog,
we
we
can
can
see
see
the
the
same
same
feature.
feature.
As
As
we
we
can
can
see
see
here
here
list,
list,
some
some
filter,
filter,
some
some
search
search
feature,
feature,
and
and
sorting
sorting
related
related
things.
things.
So
So
for
for
that,
that,
we
we
need
need
to
to
create
create
a
a class
class
in
in
our
our
project.
project.
So
So
that
that
class,
class
we
we are
are
going
going
to
to
create
create
an
an
admin
admin
interface.
interface.
So
So
for
for
that,
that,
we
we
need
need
to
to
add
add
some
some
code
code
in
in
our
our
admin.py.
admin.py.
So
So
for
for
that,
that,
here
here
we
we
can
can
create
create
a
a
model
model
admin,
admin,
model
model
admin.
admin.
So
So
model
model
admin
admin
name
name
will
will
be
be
a
a
post
post
admin.
admin.
You
You
can
can
put
put
our
our
own
own
name,
name,
but
but
I'm
I'm
going
going
to
to
use
use
similar
similar
pattern.
pattern.
This
This
is
is
our
our
database
database
name,
name,
model
model
name,
name,
and
and I'm
I'm
going
going
to
to
use
show
title
title
here.
here. Let
Let
me
me
put
put
one
one
list
list
title.
title.
That
That
I
I
will
will
show
show
what
what
will
will
be
be
happen
happen
after
after
this.
this.
Now
Now
we
we
need
need
to
to
import
import
our
our
database.
database.
So
So
from
from
model,
model,
import
import
post.
post. So we have imported this post class from this file. That file we have specified here dot models, and this post use as we have created a class called model admin. Inherited model admin class, and we have registered admin here by using this. There is one more syntax by using a decorator we can use this, but for now we are currently using this method. So now if I refresh our browser, it will show a new entry called blog. So here we can see the blog new entry and the blog module blog app. We have a new entry called post. So now if I go to here, currently we don't have any entry here. So to add a more entry, we can simply click on this add button. All these functionality will by default provided by Django admin. So for that, we have added only couple of line of code here. So by using this three lines of code, we have created a lot of all the feature like listing, like we have created a add form. So let me add a new blog here. Now if I save this, it will save the data into database. So as we can see here, we have saved our data into table. Now we can add some more posts here. So now we have created three blogs. Now as you can see here at the top, we are getting post object three. So we it should not be the, not like this. There should be a name, like we have post title was added successfully. For that we need to make some changes in our
model. So here we have there's one more function called underscore string. So here we can give this title. So now if we add new block to this admin panel.
And here you can see there was a object 3, object 4. Now it's showing a full title here. So that is because of this we have specified this string class here. So by using string function, by default it will print a title. Otherwise, default it will print as object 1, object 2, object 3.
So now we have created our admin panel.
So next thing is to view all this in our front end. So let me create a new class in our project. So here we have a front end related changes. We can add some more function class here, and that will be visible in our front end part.
So for that, I'm going to create a new function called view post. Here, Django provides default parameter that is based. So here, we need to run some HTML code to our browser. So for that, I will write a class Django called HTTP response. So HTTP response. And here it accepts some HTML output. Output. I will need to import this HTTP response from Django, HTTP class, HTTP module, Django.HTTP import. Now, we have created a function called newPost. So, our main aim is to fetch the data from database table and that data to be visible in our browser. So, for now, I have created a function. So, next thing is to map this folder to our URL. So let me add some more URL in our project. So here, just to add a more URL, similarly we need to create this. And here I am going to put log and the class name. So class function or class name. So there you have added a view post. Now we need to import this view post from here. We need to import here. So we have imported this function from our blog module to this URL part. Now it is visible in our browser. So let me open our browser. If open log here,
you can see there is a blog, hello
part. Now our aim is to put the
our blogging related data. So to fetch this data into our view, Django provide a ORM. ORM means object relation manager. So to fetch the data, our aim is to fetch the data from database table to this view part. So for that Django provide a feature called Django ORM. So ORM normally means object relational mapping.
So that basically write a database related query in object oriented format. So we just need to write a object oriented code and that will be converted into our SQL database,
SQL query.
So let me open our browser editor, and here we need to import our model. So for that I'm going to import model, import post. So post is our model name. Now we can apply our ORM to this. Model. So by default, you provide some objects, and here you can apply it all. So it is basically run the SQL query, something like this. Select star from post. So instead of writing this, we can simply write this in our Django. So it will place this data from database table in our view. So something like this. Now we have all posts in a single variable called post. So we can go through a loop for post in post. And we can format something like this. So there are two columns available, title and body.
So body.
You can put some HTML here so that it will look bolder. So now we can remove this. Now if we refresh our page. So now we can see there's a title, body, title, body, title, body. So we are successfully placed this data from table, database table to our view. But now our aim is to use some beautiful HTML templates to organize all this data. So currently we basically use the hard code value here, but now we want to remove this, and our aim is to use the HTML template to use some beautiful view in our browser. So for that we need to configure our settings. So you know, if we go to our settings, you can see that there's a directory. By default, Django use template location in app level. But for now, I will use some specified directory here so that all templates will be in one folder instead of different folder. So for that, I will create a folder here in our project called templates. And under this folder, we will add new folder called frontend. So we have created a two folder. Under main project, we have created a template. Under template, we have created a frontend. We can create some more folder here, like backend. So for admin related changes, admin related template will be in backend folder, and for frontend related changes will be in frontend folder. So this folder doesn't recognize the Django. So for that, we need to specify the path here. So path will be something like we can specify the full path. So we can import the full, we have already put it directly. So so if you see the SQLite database, so it has given the path here. So I'm going to use this path, something like this. And here I will use this template folder. And one more folder called project. Sorry, from frontend. Now we have specified our template in our view. There is a function called render where we can render our HTML code in our browser. So let me first load our HTML related code. So we have already downloaded the HTML from the GitHub. So if I open this HTML code in our browser, so let me open
the browser. So till now we have opened this HTML theme HTML in our browser. So that will be look like something look like this. So here block title here should be block title and there's a body content. So there should be some logo and our website name here should be. There should be our website name. So let's. So for that, I have created a folder called template. Under template, we have created two folders, front end and back end. Under the front end, I have created two files, home and post.
So I have copied all the HTML related code in this post file
and HTML in the same HTML file also. And here we have created a new folder. Called public and static and front end. So under public folder we have created static and under static we have created the front end. And after that we have created the copy the CSS file from this theme folder. So from theme CSS folder we have copied the CSS file here.
Now
one more thing is left to specify our. Static file related configuration here. So it provides some default static path. So we need to specify a static directory.
So if you go to our Django website, so we need to specify some static file related code. So for that, we need to specify here our location.
So public.
Static and public slash media. So media folder is where you can upload under log related images. So under this folder we will get a new folder called media. And
under here we have one more folder called static. And
now if you refresh our page, nothing will happen.
So it's still starting.
So let me first comment this static root. Now if you open our browser, it will show same thing. So in our view, we have this. Now Django provides some shortcut to render your HTML. So if we go to our Django website and here you can find some render function. So currently I'm going to use this render function. So we paste them here. And now I will pass this context. Now we need to specify the template name. So template name will be frontend. And home. Or post. Now remove this, all these things. And under the post, we need to specify our CSS code. So So we need two things, bootstrap and JSON. So if we go to here, we need temp vendor also. So we I'm going to copy this vendor to our static folder and the folder front end. Paste them there. Now we need to specify var static slash vendor.
Yes, we can specify the front end. We need to specify the front end.
Now it's good. So here we can give your log, Django log.
Now if we go to our browser and if I refresh this, it will open a beautiful HTML page. Now our aim is to replace this dummy text into with our real data.
So for that, we need to, as you can see, we can find a pattern here. So there are four boxes. Now I'm going to remove this. And under the template, there to provide some tags. So I'm going to use that tag here. For we have passed the data post.
Post. And I'm going to copy this from here to there.
And from there,
put the title name.
We need to log in this syntax.
Title.
And there should be body. Now I'm going to now if you request our page, so here you can see we have created a title, body. If our law, our model have any images that will be displayed here. So, till now we have created our blog on home page. You can see that the date is like here. So, in next video, we will go in more detail
about our Django part, Django admin part. So, here we have lots of configuration where we can make our admin most useful for a user, where we can control our rights, we can control, we can add some more options like for the images part and for some more detail, beautiful editor. So in next video we will see them how we can implement those things into our Django part, Django admin part. And in next video we will see how we can change this Django admin part template. So